Hey guys, it's me, Hunter Ivy, and guess what I got in the mail today? The Mythical Society Chef Illegal Ships. I am very excited to open this box and try these chips out. So I've been waiting for these chips to come in the mail. So if I got them, here we are. This contains like flavors like Kazu Marzu, including horse meat and fugu, known as poison pufferfish. So I'm really excited to try these chips. So I can't wait to try them. So I'm going to open this box, review the chips, flavor by the flavors, what they have, and see. Fourth box. I know there's four bags in here because I heard there's a mystery one too in here. So, I'm going to get my knife and get this. Let's get this started. Fugu one. Oh yeah, I want to try one of these. And the next one we got is Kazu Marzu. So again, Kazu Marzu. I'm really gonna try this out. And we got horse meat. I wonder what the last one is. Oh, it's another horse meat. Okay, so we got two bags of horse meat. Okay, so I'm hoping for another flavor, but I guess we got two bag of horse meat. Okay, so what we got here is chips that are made from Good Mythical Morning. Mythical Chef Josh made these chips himself. So yeah, first like horse meat. So Kazu Marzu and even now, I have heard of these foods before. I have heard of these delicacies in each country that are in it. Let's discuss fugu, pufferfish. Pufferfish is actually a delicacy in Japan. Now, there is one state where they do serve pufferfish. It is New York. There is a street, it's actually basically called a street grill in New York, actually used to serve pufferfish. Of course, the people that actually serve it do have licenses, they know how to serve it, they know how to cut it up and everything. There's even a video that shows the street chefs how they prepare it and everything, and it's on YouTube if you want to go see that video and stuff. I'll put it on the screen, I'll put the link in the description box below. But anyway, I'm really excited to try these and see what it's like. I've heard everything about, pufferfish, because if it's not, done right, it will kill you. Yeah, it will kill you if it's not done right. And this is why it's banned in the U.S. to serve people and stuff. And so yeah, I'm really excited to have these flavored chips. And this is the only legal way they can do it, which is actually nice. Yeah. So I like the packaging. I like the packaging he has. I like the nutrition facts he puts on there and stuff. Nice packaging. This packaging is awesome, by the way. It's so the packaging is really awesome. And there's Mythical Chef Josh right there. Yeah, I love Good Mythical Morning. They make great videos, and it's awesome to review these products. And the next one we got here is also horse meat. Now, let me just talk about horse meat. Horse meat is another delicacy in some countries. From what I read, it is a delicacy in countries like the UK and also the other countries that are definitely not here in the US. Our things are not in here in the US because horse meat is actually illegal in the US. According to the FDA, it's not served here because no one wants to eat a horse. No one wants to eat a horse. So I'm really curious what this chili tastes like. I've never had horse meat. I've heard of horse meat, heard of delicacy, but I'm not sure if I'm going to eat horse meat. But I have heard there's some good health benefits with horse meat. I have heard some good things about eating horse meat, but I'm not going to, you know, go to a country and just try it because I'm not sure how I feel about that. But I'm curious to try this flavor and see what it tastes like. And then last but not least, we also have Cosmarsen. Now, I'm really curious to try this one because I've heard so much stuff about Cosmarsen. Now, Cosmarsen is this cheese they have in Sardinia, Italy. In Sardinia, Italy, they actually serve this cheese there, and it's called Cosmarsen. Let me give you a description of what it's like. Cosmarsen is basically a maggot cheese, and this cheese it has maggots in it. They're alive in there because apparently, they let this cheese like age for a while to the point where the flies just come in and lay the eggs into the cheese. And then, of course, the maggots hatch in there and they're still crawling in the cheese. And the cheese is like really like rotten inside and stuff. And that's how they serve it. Now, when I first heard of this cheese, I was really curious to try because I've heard people say they like it and they say they actually it's pretty good. And it's only best to eat it with live maggots. You can't really chill it. You have to get it at room temperature. You cannot really chill it because it would kill the maggots. And you have to excessively wrap it in tin foil and also plastic and all that kind of stuff. And yeah, you have to really wrap it up with plastic and saran wrap. Keep it fresh. And yeah, it's definitely not possible to get in the U.S. because it is banned by the FDA and banned in the U.K. because of maggots and the cheese. So yeah, I've ate bugs before. I've ate crispy crickets. You can buy roasted crickets online and just eat them. Yeah, I've done a video about that before years ago, and it was pretty interesting to it, and they're actually not bad to eat, by the way, and stuff. So I'm definitely going to try one of these chips. So I'm going to try the one that I'm really interested in trying is the Fugu one, the one that's, definitely mostly talked about. So we're going to try the Fugu one. Let's see how it smells. No, it's just like regular chips. Smells like regular chips. And also, let's see the texture of these chips. That's what chips look like. Looks like a regular potato chip. But let me see how it tastes. Okay, that's a very interesting taste. It does have sort of like a little bit fishy and a little bit tingle to it as well. And I've read that pufferfish has a little bit of a tingle to it whenever you taste it. I've never tasted pufferfish before. But after tasting this chip, I'm pretty sure I've probably experienced the way you get from tasting a pufferfish. And I heard pufferfish has been served in a lot of ways, like you can have it deep fried and have it boiled, and also you have it serve raw, but make sure you have to cut the liver away from the meat because the liver is the most toxic thing that you not want to consume. So, these chips are not bad. These actually are pretty good chips. And they're low flavor and pretty addicting. They look like favorite chips. I definitely feel a little tingle to it, but like rare chips, but it all tastes pretty good. Not bad, they're actually pretty good. Pretty good. So I wanted to drop the other ones. All right, next one is horse meat. definitely taste the meat flavor consistency into this one. It does taste like a bit like a hamburger. It's like a bit bland to a really seasoned hamburger. Yeah, it tastes very rare. Like, it tastes like a, you know, rare steak. I don't know if that's what horse meat tastes like, but this is really an interesting flavor for chip. If you know what horse meat tastes like, let me know in the comments box below. I want to know what your taste buds are like for horse meat. I'm very curious to know. Even though I can't have it in the U.S., but I'm curious what they taste like. Tastes like in your country. If you live in a country that they really serve it, please let me know what it tastes like. They're pretty good. I like the flavor. It's like a seasoned steak flavor. It's like a really seasoned steak flavor. Smell of cheese, really. I mean, that cheese is aroma is just strong. It just hits you right there. Really, I'm curious to try one of these. Wow, that's strong. Okay, that is strong. That's a very pungent, cheesy taste right there. Even for a chip, that's actually stronger than Gouda. Stronger than blue, a little stronger than blue cheese too. I mean, I've tasted blue cheese, and I love blue cheese, but this is like stronger than blue cheese. Wow. Flavor, I mean, I imagine that's what Kazumaru tastes like. You've not ever had Kazumaru, but I'm pretty sure it's what it tastes like. And, I mean, wow, it's definitely strong. Wow. Just, wow, that's strong. That's pretty good. Very good thing, too. It's like my teeth. That's one problem about potato chips, that you get something. So those were the chips that Mythical Josh made. I have to say, they're pretty good chips. They're actually really addicting. They're really flavorful. They're actually seasoned very well. And surprisingly, they're good. Of course, they're like regular chips you have in the grocery store. Like regular chips you have in the grocery store. But this reminds you, these are only flavors that they actually made themselves. So, yeah. Yeah. Granted, I'm not sure if viewers are watching this may think that is what these foods actually really taste like. If they ever try them and stuff. If you ever try these foods that these chips are representing, let me know in the comment box below. I'm really curious what these foods would taste like to you if you ever taste them. Because I really want to know. But anyway, as far as these chips go, these chips are pretty good. I'd say they're well done. They're really actually, you know, very flavorful, and I like the texture, the flavor is actually very nice. So and the seasoning is actually good too. So yeah, I have to get these chips. 5 out of 5. I mean, yeah, they're pretty good. And, yeah, get your friends to try them. Get your friends and family to try them. See what they think. I especially recommend the Kazumaru is the best one because that aroma, that cheese aroma, and these chips. I mean, I have to say, they're pretty good. And the horse meat one is also good too. I actually especially love the seasoning, especially the flavor. It tastes just like a steak. steak. It tastes just like a steak, like a rare, rare steak. It's basically. And the popular fish one tastes a little fishy, but it's definitely got a little bit of a different feel to it when you first bite into it. I'm gonna take another bite. When it comes to fish, I tasted fish, and this is like really different than most fish I've tasted. Yeah, so yeah, there's all the illegal chips that are very interesting. Yeah, there you go. Today's video of me reviewing these illegal chips that are from Good Mythical Morning and made by Mythical Chef Josh. If Mythical Chef Josh is watching this, these are really good chips. I'd say they're really good. I never tasted these foods that these chips are based on in person. I mean, it'll be really nice to go to these countries and where these foods are from to see if I can actually try them and everything. If I have a good chance to, you know, have the money and all that other stuff to do, visit countries that have these sort of foods. Yeah, I really am curious to try them. Try the real stuff and see what it tastes like. Yeah, I'm a traveler, I do like to travel, and I do like to try everything because I am a food taster. I do like to eat a lot of foods, especially ones that I'm very curious to try. So, yeah, do I recommend you buy these chips? Absolutely, yes. I mean, these chips are pretty good. They're good with sandwiches, they're good with other appetizers if you want. Appetizers or your lunch or anything like that. I guess I'll put these on my lunch. I'm gonna have this lunch and stuff. So, I gotta say, these chips are pretty good. Definitely a 5 out of 5 right there. All three chips are good. I think the best one, in my opinion, has to be Positive Mars. I give the one a 4.3 out of 5. It's got a good texture and good flavor to it. Horse meat, I like the flavor, I like the fact it tastes like a rare steak. So I get a 4.7 out of 5. And I give Costume Marsu a 4.8 out of 5. That's what I give it. I like the flavor of Costume Marsu, it looks really, it smells really nice, and the oh, cheese, so I especially love that flavor. It's really nice. It's really good. I'm pretty sure these are baked chips, because judging by the texture of these chips, I think they're like baked, because they don't look fried to me. They could be fried, I don't know. But anyway, if you try these chips, let me know in the comment box below and see what you think of them compared to the real thing. If you manage to like compare it to the real thing and stuff. But anyway, I love these chips. These chips are pretty good. Hey guys, Hunter, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys later. On our video. See you guys later.